Okay, so good afternoon class. Okay ba yung audio?
Sir.
Okay, good.
Yes, sir.
So attendance muna tayo, section 1, COI. Okay, attendance ang?
Present, sir.
Bukol. Bukol?
Present, sir. Present, sir.
Burns.
Present, sir. Sir, present.
Cachero.
Sir, present. Sir, present.
Galvez.
Sir, present.
Gambon. Gambon. Wala pa. Hernais.
Present, sir.
Makabitas. Jude.
Present, sir.
Marzan.
Present, sir.
Mosquito.
Sir, present.
Ordilio.
Sir, present.
Tarpanot.
Present, sir. Sir, present.
Rivera.
Sir, present.
Samson. Paul. Andre. Absent. Tan.
Sir, present. Present. Sir, present. Sir, present.
Tino. Samson, present. Tan.
Sir, present.
Present, sir, present.
Cabigas.
Yes, sir.
Mendoza.
Sir, present.
Pagaduan.
Sir, present.
Quinzon.
Present, sir.
Okay, good. Okay, so this week, Google. So our topic for this week will be more on the camera connection. So in our Google Classroom, I've already posted the sample code and the DLL. So today I'll be demonstrating to you on how to connect your camera application or camera. I mean your camera to your software application. So I'll be using the Sharp Develop kasi yung Visual Studio is not yung Visual Studio is licensed kasi.
Sir.
Yes, sino yun?
Wala tang naman yung camera on connection.
Oh, kasi i-demo ko pa. Ito na, i-demo ko na lang siya. So I'll be using the OBS for recording our ito, Google Meet and yung demonstration. So, i-demo ko pa lang yan. Paano? Okay, so let's start. Sharp Develop ang gagamitin ko kasi yung Visual Studio is licensed. So, hindi ko siya pwedeng install dito sa laboratory. Kasi baka alam nila na magkaroon ng issue yung license ng Microsoft. Anyway, pareho lang naman sila yung Sharp Develop and the VS or the Visual Studio. So, let's create a... Wait. Check ko lang kung nagre-record, nagre-record naman. Okay, so let's create an application. So, Windows application and then name, camera. Camera application. So, create. So, for this project, so we need to have a, based from our code. Doon na lang tayo magbase sa code natin. Okay, so based from our code, we need to have, yeah, the following DLL. We'll be using the AForge for controlling our webcam. So, na-upload ko na ba yun? Check ko nga. Yan yung mga DLL files natin. It's already uploaded. So, incorporate muna natin in our reference. So, first, let's go to the projects and let's add the reference, add references. And then... A-Polish DLL. Okay, so add lang natin, browse, and then A-Polish DLL, select all na lang natin, open, and okay. So situate na yung reference natin, kompleto. So we have the A-Polish control, imaging, mat, video, and video direct show. Okay, so once na meron na tayong mga DLL, then next is we have the UI. Okay, so maglalagay tayo. So first, drop down. Double check ko nga sa codes natin. Anong ginamit? Drop down. O nga pala yung reference natin. Anyway, nandito naman yung codes natin. No need na. Basahin na lang natin tong codes. Combo box. Okay, so maglagay tayo ng combo box. So the combo box will show all the available webcam in our unit. And then meron tayong button for the start. So ang pangalan na lang, same na lang dito. Button. Capture. Save. Button capture. BTN capture the name and then text. Dapat start yun. So, let me start. Button start. Okay, so meron tayong combo box. Name of the combo box. Ayan. Combo camera. Ayan. Okay. And then we need to have another panel. Picture box. So, yan. So, for the meantime, yun muna. So, dito sa drop-down natin, dito magpapakita yung mga available webcams. And then, when we click the start button, then it will connect yung application to our webcam and then it will show it in this part, yung picture box natin. Okay. And then, for the codes, form load. By the way, balik tayo sa codes natin. Don't forget to put yung using. So, using A-Polish, imaging, video, and video direct show. Copy na lang natin. And then, let's go to our code. Source. So, idagdag natin dito. So, we have the A-Polish imaging, video, and direct show. Then, next step is, natin sa source natin. We have the main form, initialize component for the components. Example of components, yung mga form, text box, and etc. Buttons, yun yung initial components natin. And then, next is, we have this one. This one is for a variable. Ito yung mga variable na pwede natin gamitin for the collection of data and for the video capture. So, this is a global. Pag sinabing natin global, although naka-private siya, these are global variables. Ibig sabihin, pwede nating tawagin on the private functions or modules. Ayan. Dito. So for example, here the, we have the all call camera. That one. Call camera, and then we have the capture device. Saan natin ginamit yung capture device? This one. Okay? So yan yung gamit ng dalawa. So we created an object for global, or this is these are the variables. Yan. Call camera. Yan. Call camera and capture device. And these are the parang data types niya. For the call camera, we have the filter info collection, and then we have the capture device for video capture device naman. Next, so we have the main form load. Ganito ang main form load. So once you load, I mean, once your application is started, so pag clinic mo yung start, and then nag-start na yung program natin or yung project natin, then gagawin na niya na yung set of codes natin. So to do that, we have a lot of methods to do that. Click mo lang tong icon, yung camera, or any here sa frame natin, and then here meron kayong main form, and then we have the events. For the events, yan, click lang natin tong load. So main form load, double click. So ginawa ko is double click lang. So yan. Never been used, kaya siya ganyan, kasi hindi pa daw siya nagamit. But later on, gagamitin din natin. So, ito yung codes natin. So, first, we have the fill drop-down camera. This is a, gumawa siya ng sarili niyang function. So, open and close parenthesis. Method or function, pareho lang sila. So, gumawa siya ng sarili niyang function. So, this is the function. Yan. Copy ko na lang, parang sumbilis. Ito ko na encode. So first we have the form main form load. So once na nag-load yung form natin, gagawin niya to. So fill in the drop down camera. Kinol lang niya to. Okay? Once na kinol niya yan, we have the call camera. Ano yung call camera? This one. For the filter information collection from our drives, yung mga naka-install sa unit natin ng mga webcam. And then yan, so ipifilter niyo yung mga categories, input, and etc. For each, ibig sabihin niyo, iisa-isahin niyo yung mga drivers or yung mga devices natin in our unit. And then, i-display niya sa combo camera. And our combo camera is this one, combo box. Ang name niya is combo camera. Okay? Combo camera. And then, it will add all the items. And it will display the device name. And then, meron tayong mga index. So, yung first na magpapakita doon is we have the index 0. Yung first the camera. And then, so on the like. And then, yeah, capture device. For this one, kung ano yung sa-select nating webcam later on. So, yun na yung pipili niya. Run. So here, kung mapapansin nyo, medyo maliit. Yan. Ito yung mga set of cameras that are available in my unit. But actually, isa lang, the PC camera. Yung PC camera is yung, nandito, naka-install na webcam. These are only a virtual camera, yung ginagamit sa OBS. This one, this is the virtual camera. Mayroon itong virtual camera. Okay. So this is the index 0, index 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on the like. So let's go back to our code. Okay, so we're done with the fill-in drop-down camera. So next is start button. So once na nag-start yung, we click the start button, then it will play the video, the webcam. Start, double click. Ginawa ko lang doon is double click. Okay, then button start click, then in our code, ayan. So first, we have to capture the new device from our combo camera, selected index. Okay, ayan. So i-copy lang natin to. So from our button. Ayan. Then next is Yan, and then capture device and then start method. So, i-start nyo na yung pag-play. Then, yeah. We have here, if you will notice in our code, meron tayong final frame, new frame, so that it will play yung video. And then it will display that in our picture box. This is the picture box. Pinatlan niya. Anyway, this is the name na ginamit in our code. We have pick video. So dito, in our design, we should change na lang the name of the picture box to pick video kasi yun yung ginamit in our reference. Pick video. So, the name of the picture box is pick video. Na. So, punta tayo sa code. And then, we have to create this one with final frame that new frame. So, gagawa tayo ng isa pa ditong method or function for the final frame new frame. Copy. And then paste. Yeah. Bakit bitmap ang ginagamit for the video? Actually, for the bitmap, this is the default data or media for the video. Bitmap. And then clone, and then after cloning, it will display yung dito, yung video 1 in our picture pick video. Natalas mo na pang wala na. Okay, so for the meantime muna, let's run the program, camera, start. Hindi niya pinapakita. Or baka may kulang pa sa codes natin. Final frame, then display that in our video, pick video. Tama naman, that image. Dito, this is the method for closing the camera. By the way, if you notice, if you run the program, okay, and you closed, okay lang siya. Nag-stop siya. But when you click the start button, yun nga lang bakit. Ayaw nga pala, I forgot. The OBS is using the camera. It's using the camera, so that's why I cannot use the camera in my application. So, gamitin ko na lang virtual camera. Okay, ulitin ko ulit. Bakit hindi ko ma-call yung camera dito? In here, in my program. Because the camera, webcam, is, the OBS is using my webcam. Ito, hindi niya ma-call. So, gagamitin ko na lang virtual camera. So, I'll be using the OBS camera. Virtual camera. Yan. Ano yung OBS camera? This one? So, this is the OBS camera. Yan. Kikita siya dyan. Anyway. And then, next is, by the way, dito yung properties niya. Okay. If you notice, I started the camera. Nag-start ako ng camera. And then, when I close the form, nag-run pa rin yung program. Actually, the program is still running because of the camera. Okay, nakakonect pa rin yung camera natin sa application. So, click stop. And then in our source code, we need to call the function for closing the camera. So, here, kailangan natin, main form, form closed. Paano tayo pupunta dito sa main form closed? Actually, this is an event. So, in our design, form, and then in our events, you can see a form closed. This one, form closed. Double click lang. Or you can select, wala. Double click. Ganun. So, main form closed. So, once na nag-close na yung form natin, so, our camera should close. Yan. So dapat magko-close siya. Let's try to run. Oop, component close bracket. Actually this is a function pala. So we need to create another method or function for this one. Kinocall lang niya. So nasaan yung camera close natin? Dito siya. Close camera, so we have void close camera. Just copy. Outside, dapat nasa labas ha? Kasi this is another function or method. Close camera. So ito, kinol niya si close camera. So if not null, hindi raw siya null. And then if the camera is still running, then stop. Okay, stop niya. Run the program. Start. So nagra-run na yan. Yan. Camera natin. And then close. Nag-stop na siya. Automatic. Because we call the close camera function. So dito siya. Then next is here, when we selected an index, pag nag-change daw tayo ng camera, then it should stop. So once, di ba nasa OBS tayo, and then kapag nag-select pa tayo ng iba, dapat our camera will close kasi gagamitin niya ng ibang camera para hindi siya mag-error. So to do that, so we have the combo camera select index change. So dito daw, combo box, we have the event. So select index change, double click. So once na nag-change tayo ng selected webcam, then we have to call also the function closed. So ito, okay, i-call pa rin niya yun para hindi siya maguluhan. So i-close muna niya isang camera bago niya gamitin ibang camera. So yun siya. And then next is okay, so let's try na tanggalin ko lang itong video capture dito. Then try ko lang kung pwede na siya dito. Wala pa rin. Ginagamit pa rin niya yung OBS camera. Doon siya sa top. Okay, anyway. Pero nagra-run ito, hindi lang niya magamit yung camera because the OBS is using that camera. Hindi pala siya na-record. Anyway, nag-record ba tayo sa ano? Sinong nagre-record? Okay, recording naman. Sinong nagre-record sa inyo? Ng video? Google Meet?
Hindi namin alam siya. Kung kanina
eh. Okay, so anyway. Nagre-record naman ito. Ibig sabihin, pag recording siya, mapupunta yan sa Google Meet natin. Iba kasi yung scene na nalagay. Ayan. Ewan kung saan namin to doon. Okay. So, ito lang naman ang nilagay ko doon. Ayan, combo. Susundan nyo lang naman yan. Susundan nyo na lang siya. If you need the my reference, A-Forge Capture ito ata hindi open ko na nga lang lahat. Hindi ito eh. Hindi rin. Ay, ito. Ayan. Ito. Ito yung reference ko dito. Ay, hindi iba. Saan siyang screenshot. Baka magamit nyo pa yun. Yung PDF format niya. Ayan ang PDF. Kung saan ko nilagay. Hindi ko na mahanap kung anong website. Anyway. Google Classroom. I-add ko siya. Material. Reference. Sa week. Week 11 pa? Week 10. Week 11. Week 10. Add the link. And then, ibigay ko na rin to sa inyo, in case na kailangan nyo to. Add the link. Post. Ayan. So, nandito na yung mga references ko, PDF, and then sample code, DLL, kompleto na, and the camera connection, later on, it will be uploaded. Dito, gamit ang OBS. By the way, kung gusto nyo makita yung kwan, nasa kwan nito, nasa Google Classroom natin. I mean, nasa email. Check your email. Itong recorded kwan natin, Google Meet natin. Do you have any question, class?
None, sir.
None,
sir.
Good.
Wala, sir.
Nahantok ka. Saan na yun? Nandito naman yung kwan. Nandito yung mga description niya, kung anong gagawin ninyo, anong gagamitin nyo. Yung mga gumagamit ng kwan Visual Studio, yan, ito yung kwan, pwede yung naging reference. Pero wala siyang capture ata to. Wala siyang capture. Anyway, madali lang naman yung capture tsaka yung pag-save. Nandun naman na sa codes natin. Now, in addition, syempre bibigyan ko din naman kayo ng trabaho kasi hindi naman lahat is dapat galing sa teacher. Diba? So, dapat meron din kayong para bang self-study. Kasi pag spoon-feeding lahat, parang konti lang yung matututunan ng estudyante.
So, sa finals na.
Hindi, madali lang naman yun. So, di ba pinapagawan ko kayo ng system? Dahil pinapagawin ko kayo ng system, dahil meron na tayong camera at saka capture. So pag capture ninyo, I want you to conduct a research about how to save naman the captured image to your database. And that will be your activity for this week. Okay?
Sir, no deadline.
No deadline? Hanggang kwan na to? Kailan ba yung sabi? Kailan ba? I-try lang natin ng until 7, December 7.
Sir, then, search lang, sir?
Sir, December 14.
You need to apply that.
Sir, December 14.
December 14, week 11. Assignment, sige, December 4, December 14, 2 weeks.
Yes, sir, matagal yan.
Oh, pero kuan na, kailangan kasali na dun sa system, sa midterm project ninyo na ipresent later on. Okay? So, activity. Di naman, sige, conduct. And apply. Conduct a research about how to save image to your database. Yeah. So conduct a research about how to save an image or image to your database using the C# language, syempre. And the MySQL Azure database.
Sir, camera?
Yeah. Ito, di ba nag-capture na siya ng... Saan na yun? So, nag-capture na siya dito. So, start natin ulit. Start tayo.
Sir, okay lang pag-browse.
Browse? Camera dapat eh. Browse, tapos magsisave. Pag-save mo, dapat magsisave siya sa database.
Yes, sir. Blob.
Okay, so yun. So, parang hindi naman lahat is galing sa teacher. Kailangan meron din galing sa student. Saan yun? Anyway, ang deadline naman yung medyo malayo naman sa akin pa. Saan yung section 1? Ito. So, conduct research, how to save, then apply it to your system, midterm project. Okay, so yun lang. So, yun, conduct research and then apply. Basta na-apply nyo na sa midterm project ninyo and then upload, by the way. Kuan na lang. Take a screenshot. Of your code. Yan lang. Take a screenshot of your code and then upload. Then upload it here. Okay? Yung code lang ah, hindi na kailangan yung research. Yung code nyo lang na i-apply nyo dun sa system ninyo. Post. Okay, so yun lang. So, no question? Wala lang question? None so far? Okay, so if you don't have any question, by the way, next meeting, our next meeting will be tomorrow. No need. Take note. Hindi na natin kailangan mag-meet tomorrow ng 2 o'clock to 3 o'clock kasi binigay ko naman na sa inyo yung mga activities and lectures for this week. Okay? Class. Diyan pa kayo.
Thanks, sir.
Okay, so yun lang. Kindly check yung email, nyo. Nandun na yung pan-recorded video natin. Okay, so if you don't have any questions, so see you next week.
See you, sir. Sir, present.
Sino? Sino pa?
Oh,
Ako saan ako? Ako.
Sino ka? Gambon. Gambon, present. We all present. Okay, anyway. Sige, see you next week.
Plus 10, all present.
Plus 40.
Sir.
Sige, sir. Bye.
Bye, sir.